Ready? Ready?
Sorry I'm late, Eddie.
Stuff on the radio this time of year.
Mom, where's he going?
And books, you see, there's always books. Many's the boxing day I've lost myself in a lem day.
Perhaps your conscience won't let you celebrate the birth of our saviour.
Nothing on my conscience, Mrs. Marley.
Not even the death of my son.
Is this one about 5 feet?
Begging you. We want a traditional Christmas like everybody else. That telly goes on at 7 in the morning, stays on till midnight.
All right, so this is about tradition.
Yeah. That's right. That's right.
The magic of Christmas.
Yeah, that's it.
Well, I'd get them quick if I was you and write a letter to Santa.
Two... 75 to 80 £3.
It's 5 quid, Joyce, like it always is.
But we're saving up, you see.
Oh, really? I never read anything about it in the Financial Times.
It's for one of them chair lifts. Joyce's arthritis, you know.
It's giving me 10 types of chip.
There's nothing worse.
The air's blue when I'm going up them stairs.
Think about it, Eric. A chairlift at Joyce's time of life? Well, that can be a lethal piece of equipment in the wrong hands. You press the wrong button and, well, it could be Horlicks for one, if you get my meaning.
The
it can be a godsend, Eddie.
So I'll be having the other £2, Joyce, and remember, I'm doing it for you.
Mr. Scrooge, I mean, I was, like, thinking about maybe borrowing some more, like...
That's what I love about you, Ted. You know how to enjoy yourself. Calculator, Bob.
Yeah, only I was thinking of going to see my daughter in Australia one last time. I'm not getting any younger.
I had a family of my own once, Ted. I really don't need to hear about yours. Now, the fare to Australia is what?
I think I'll get a special offer, about £700.
Bob. I can do £10 a week over 10 years, and I'm robbing myself.
It's a bit steep, isn't it?
Well, that's the global economy for you.
About tomorrow, with it being Christmas Day, I was thinking I'd like to spend it with my family.
Well, there's no accounting for taste. I thought I told you to get rid of those.
Oh, I did, though. The police must have put more up.
Oi, get out of it! Well, go on, get out of it! I mean, if you're gonna be homeless, why not be homeless outside a stately home or something? Kids these days, no ambition. You know what I love about Christmas Day, Bob? Everybody's at home.
Yeah, it's good that families are together.
And what better news for a debt collector than everybody being at home? So, bright and early tomorrow morning, then you'll be home in time for your burnt turkey drumstick.
Well, Tim's in hospital again. I was thinking more of the whole day.
And I was thinking of inviting Britney Spears over for an eggnog.
I'll take that as a no then, shall I?
You got any spare change so I can get a cup of tea? Nice one, mate. Cheers.
She doesn't want your drinks. She doesn't want anything from you.
People keep telling me it's Christmas.
That's right. Just as long as you know that it won't be Bella on the other end of your cracker this year.
Sorry, Uncle Eddie. I didn't mean to make a show of you. I can't stop, I'm on duty. I was just wondering if you're doing anything for Christmas Day.
No.
Oh, great, because well, that is Jane and me. We'd like you to come around for your dinner.
No.
We'd really love to see you. It's Christmas time.
Well, that's right, it's Christmas time. When the stupid and the bone idle join forces to celebrate the birth of catalogue shopping.
We'll set a place for you in case you change your mind. It's what Mum would have wanted.
Why don't you invite this lot? We deserve each other.
Big issue, mister.
Get a job.
Big issue?
Eddie.
Thank you.
Eddie, we need to talk.
All right. I'm always talking to the dead.
You don't believe in me.
You're right, I don't.
Listen, man. I haven't got time for this. I'm dead, you're not. Seems to me that gives me the upper hand. Message-wise.
You are not here!
You can't front me out. I'm deceased. Look.
All right. Talk.
You're gonna get 3 visitors.
I'll bake a cake.
I'd treat them with respect if I were you. I might just stop you ending up like me.
Well, how do you mean? Dead.
There's worse things than dying.
Do you remember when you died?
Why are you so interested?
No reason. Just wonder what it was like for you.
Sudden.
What's with the chains?
What, these? They're just bad stuff I did that I never put right.
What sort of bad stuff? Is that why you're here? Is that why you've come back?
Eddie!
Dad.
Oh, come on. You're not going to bottle it, are you? Come on, son.
I'm the ghost of Christmas past. It's a bummer of a job, but when did I ever get lucky, eh?
I mean, how can you be the ghost of Christmas past? You ruined Christmas for me.
Oh, for Pete's sake. How was I to know the damn Scalextrics didn't have a plug on it?
I'm not talking about the Scalextrics, you stupid old...
We commit the body of Elizabeth Jane Scrooge to the ground. Earth to earth, dust to dust, ashes to ashes. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Look at you. You couldn't touch us. You couldn't even put your arms around us.
She's in heaven already. You look at her, sister.
Help
wanted to, but I couldn't. It felt like the end of the world.
Oh, yeah, and it was a regular fairground ride for us. Our mum had just died.
Look, I didn't know what to do, son.
You were a grown-up. We were 10 years old.
Where's Dad?
I don't know.
Why are you showing me this stuff?
Don't ask me. I'm not in charge.
I want Dad.
If you go to sleep, then Dad will come. Because he loves us and he wants to look after us. But he's just not very good at it. And that's where he's gone. That's where he goes every night, to Dad's school, to learn how to look after us.
Well, the pub, as it was better known.
What's all this?
Eddie got them for us.
Mm-hmm. Does Eddie mind telling us where he got it from?
There's money and everything.
I see that. I want to know where you got it from.
We needed money, you said. I got some. Now you won't have to work so hard.
Did you steal all of this?
No.
Don't lie to me. Did you steal it?
No, kids gave it to me.
Don't tell lies!
They gave it to me. I hit them a bit and they gave it to me. I did it for you.
You did what? You stupid...
You always had to take things too far, didn't you?
And I wonder where I got that from.
Oh, that's right. Blame me. It's what you've done all your life. Don't walk away from me. Show some respect for the dead.
Are you lost, love?
I was, but now I've found you.
Head injury, is it?
Heart. It's beating like a drum. I might need mouth to mouth.
If I had a pound for every chancer who tried that line.
Yeah, well, I'm not a chancer.
It's a pity. Kind of had a soft spot for chancers.
What time's your shift finished? Maybe we could go for a drink.
Sure. I get off at 7 in the morning.
Come here often. How could she resist?
Let's see how it turned out, eh?
There's something I need to tell you.
No, me first. But this last year, well, it's been the best year of my life.
Yeah, I'm sorry to bother you, Mr. Scrooge.
Not now, Ted.
Amelia, that's all I can manage this week. I went a bit silly on the scratch card.
Some other time, all right, Ted?
Yeah, don't be like that. Look, I promise, I'll try a lot harder next.
I'm sorry about that. He's an old mate.
They always are. Do you know, every time I see you squeezing money out of people, I feel like I don't know you at all.
That isn't real. This is what's real. You and me.
But I hate what you do, and you know that. And you still won't change. And I can't live like that anymore. I'm sorry.
Will you marry me?
Eddie, didn't you hear me? This is not working.
Oh, I am. I think you'll find it is.
It's very shiny.
Well, it should be for the price.
I can take this. That's what I've been trying to tell you.
What, 5,512 quid and you're turning it down?
It's not about the price of the ring.
I know that.
No, you don't. You think that everything has a price tag, don't you? Even love.
You think I care about this? 5,500, gone. It's just us. Now, will you marry me?
There is no us. There never can be. I'm sorry, Ed.
Right, get your hands off that!
You should have gone after her.
You know, I thought when you died it might have stopped you from giving me advice, but oh no, not you.
I've been sent back here to remind you that life is full of second chances.
What, like you gave us after Mum died?
I never wanted you to be unhappy.
I don't think you wanted anyone to be happy ever again after Mum died.
Well, I've changed. Even me. And you can too.
Oh, what, be like you mean? You're joking, aren't you? I mean, look at you. Your bargain basement. You're a nothing. Everything I've done, everything I've got, I've done for me on my own without any help from anybody else. So why would I want your help?
Because I can see you're not happy.
You know what happy is? It's a painkiller for losers. And I ain't a loser. I'm not like you.
I'm your dad. And I want what's best for you.
Well, it may have passed you by, but I'm doing fine without you or any of Santa's little helpers. Dad?
Happy Christmas, everyone.
I've called it Chris Steele this morning.
The trots and nausea and vomiting. On the train on the way down.
Oh, well, it was you, was it, we heard about? Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Could I just have a
quick word?
Sorry, I'm late, Eddie. I have to stop off at the hospital.
Do you want the morning off? Christmas Day, family, chestnuts roasting on the fan heater.
It's not Christmas Day, is it? Christmas Eve.
Oh, yeah, right. I'm the fairy on top of the tree.
No, it is Christmas Eve. Look, the shop's still open. Eddie? Are you all right?
It is Christmas Eve, isn't it?
I tell you, Bob, I don't know what old Rashid puts in that cider of his. I had a weird dream last night.
Well, yeah, he would.
I dreamt the old man came to see me.
Mr. Rashid?
No, my dad in the dream.
Oh, I see.
Bob, do we ever have Christmas Eve twice in this country, you know, like in a leap year?
No, I don't think so. I'll check.
No, I didn't think we did. Bob, you're a gambling man.
Oh, I like a flutter on the national. The wife does the lottery. She had four numbers come up once, but they was all on different weeks.
What odds would you give me that I can tell you exactly what's going to happen?
Is this one about 5 feet?
I can't believe it.
Sock. I'm in a hurry.
Mr. Scrooge?
Thinking of going to Australia, Ted?
Yeah, I was actually.
It's your daughter that lives out there, isn't it?
Yeah. Didn't we tell her before?
Well, I can do 10 quid a week over 10 years.
The answer's no, Dave.
Oh.
Well, you were going to ask me whether I wanted to spend Christmas Day with you and your wife, weren't you?
Well, yeah. It would be a place set. That's what Mum would have wanted, Uncle Eddie.
Yeah, she would have done, wouldn't she? I thought about you last night when I saw her.
You saw Mum? You're making fun of me, Uncle Eddie.
Look, I've got to go. I'm expecting visitors.
Oh, who's that then?
I don't know yet.
Big issue, mister?
Oh, big issue you, from one end of the road to the other, unless you get your bony ass off my step!
To roll the cow onto its back.
Well, come on, I'm ready! I said, I'm ready! You promised me 3 ghosts, Marley. You promised me 3!
Ready?
Eddie.
Styles. What were you doing travelling about in the dark, man? I was supposed to meet Eddie down it.
Hey! Cool it, Eddie. I told you I'd be coming back.
Why can't you just walk through a wall like the rest of the living dead?
I needed a rest. Now, these chains are a bitch.
Yeah, well, you always did like your jewelry.
Not funny. Not for a man who's messed up as much as you have, conscience-wise.
Yeah, well, it's not me that rattles when I walk, is it?
You think you haven't got any chains, Ellie? You just can't see them yet.
I am the ghost of Christmas present. Look upon me.
You're it.
We're having a double up. It's the busiest night of the year, haunting-wise.
All right. But I don't want to see Bella again. I'll go anywhere with you. But no more Bella.
Come on. It's showtime.
And pay attention this time.
Excuse me, have you got any spare change to get some food? Excuse me, Dad.
They'll be on some kind of scam, Mark. You give people like that too many handouts, they don't want to work.
Merry Christmas, love.
Merry Christmas, sweetheart.
What have they got to be so happy about?
Every Christmas they count their blessings.
But that can't take them too long.
They're in love. They've been in love since the day they met. 51 years ago.
Imagine that.
It's only just begun. Oh, it's lovely.
Thanks, Father. Christmas is come.
Morning. Why is she filling their heads with that nonsense? She's poor, the kids will be poor. She's giving them dreams. She's filling their heads with broken promises. They've got nothing. I wouldn't say that.
So, have we finished the tour of the sad people yet?
What makes you think they're sad?
We'll put it this way, I wouldn't swap places with any of them.
And do you think any of them would want to swap places with you?
One day, maybe.
Oh, I'm sorry, love. I just can't believe he lets you down year after year and you keep forgiving him.
He took me in when Mum died, and I'll never forget it.
Nope, and I'll never forget that he tried to charge you for bed and breakfast.
That was just because he was angry that I joined the police cadets, that's all.
I don't know why you're always making excuses for him.
Because he's family. And he was the only family that I had until you came along. When I see him, it's not an angry man that I see. It's not some thug. It's a lonely man.
Oh, so he's a lonely shark. There's me thinking he was a lone shark.
All right, I'll get it over with. Uncle Eddie.
If you must. Uncle Eddie. Right.
Come on, we've got things to do, man. People see. I won't stay. Well, you should have come when Dave invited you then, shouldn't you?
Oh, be good with Eddie.
I think it's better having Christmas in hospital.
Oh, how'd you work that one out then?
Well, there's all the other kids to play with. And, well, everybody cheers up. When I get bored of my car, I can swap it with Azif, because he's got an action man.
Well, I hadn't seen it like that before, but you might be right there, sweetheart.
Father Christmas gave me one more thing. Merry Christmas, love.
Oh, come, Bob. We said no presents. We can't afford it.
It wasn't me. It was Father Christmas. Oh. It's a bracelet. I've kept the receipt.
Oh, it's beautiful. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Oh, I'm sorry. I get a bit crabby with you, love.
No, you don't.
I do. But it is hard, you know. You're so lovely with the kids. It's like I'm always the one who has to stand up to them and spoil the fun.
There's no secret. I just let them walk all over me.
Oh, and it's not just them, is it?
Let's not get onto that screw.
I gave him Christmas Day off.
No, listen, just hear me out. This time next year, I don't want you to be working for him.
Well, that's easier said than done, though.
Oh, come on. You hate that job, and every day I can see it eating away at you, and I don't want you to be sucked into his world.
Well, he already has been.
I owe him too much money. We're just going to have to live with it.
No, you are. I won't do it, Bob. I won't stand by and watch you destroy the good in you for the sake of Eddie Scrooge. See, that's what comes from getting him overexcited. It's all right, it's all right. Just breathe. Just breathe slowly. That's it. That's it. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. Calm down.
Eddie? Bella!
Kinky. 2 minutes.
Merry Christmas, kid.
Yeah, Merry Christmas.
Oh, you're not still moping about Eddie Scrooge, are you?
I knew it was you putting her off.
I can't help it, it was this time of year.
So, a double celebration. Christmas and getting away from him.
And what would you know?
I can't pretend I didn't love him. I can't just switch it off. I wish I could.
Come on. It's been 12 months. You could have had another 12 engagement parties since then.
It's different for you. You're
a slapper. I know. But a happy slapper.
I was going to say resilient. No, I just think maybe he would have changed if I'd stayed with him.
No. Once a bad one, always a bad one.
Shut up. Come on, Eddie. You're not supposed to be here.
He was so He was so the one. I don't know, I'd look at him sometimes and it felt like the world made sense.
Oh. Did you read that in a card or did you make it up yourself? Do you know what you sound like? One of those battered wives we get in. They always think the husbands are going to change. And every time they come in with a broken nose or a black eye, they say, this time, it'll be different. You, my girl, had a lucky escape.
Don't listen to her, Bella. Listen to what your heart's telling you. I love you. I can change. If you love me, I can do anything.
That was just degrading, Eddie.
How can you say that? I said that I'd change, you heard me.
Talk about shallow. Everything we saw tonight, what gets to you? Your love life. Self, self, self.
What, and you really think the rest of the world cares about anything else?
I'll make it simple. You love Bella because you want something back of her.
So?
That's not love. That's greed.
And that's not English. It's...
You gotta learn how to give, Eddie. And you got all day tomorrow to learn it.
You know something? You're more annoying dead than you were alive.
Yeah. The difference is there's nothing you can do about it. Now I'm dead.
How do you mean? Who are they?
Couple of kids that died tonight.
They look familiar.
They should do. You saw them every day.
What?
Brother and sister. Died within 2 hours of each other. Hypothermia. Still Eddie. Like you say. Was probably a scam.
Yellow shots and nausea and vomiting on the train on the way down.
Oh, it was you, was it? We had to pull it in at Stanford for a clean out.
Very embarrassed.
Today, Ted, it's Christmas. Now, Bob, that woman, Ellie,
the one with the three kids, how much does she owe us?
Original debt, 300, with interest, 932.
Okay, let her off 200. Go on, cross it off.
I don't really get this.
Oh, and why is that? Because I'm a...
No, I wouldn't say that.
No, but I bet you that's what you think.
No. Who told you that?
Now... That sick kiddie of yours, the one with a bad chest, Tom.
Tim, yes, cystic fibrosis.
Yeah, well, you tell him that Eddie Scrooge has given his dad a week off.
Right.
Oh, make sure you tell all the nurses at the hospital that, too.
The nurses?
Yeah, especially if any of them are called Bella.
What are you doing, Mr. Scrooge?
I'm being nice. Write it down.
But I don't want anything else. I owe you enough to eat.
Think of it as a loyalty card.
Oh.
It's a present, you stupid loser! A present. Right. Now you keep it, or Santa might just lose his temper.
Thank you, sir. Oh, bless you, merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismiss. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us all from Satan's
power. Take this, Mr. Scrooge. Now, look, I'll just put it in your pocket. You can have it.
Oh,
come on, Mr. Scrooge. Just take it, will you? Just take it, will you? Oh, yeah.
It's an old tradition. It's all the rage in parts of Norway.
Mrs. Marley. Mrs. Marley, I'd like to talk to you about your son.
What about my son?
Well, as you know, me and Marley, we were good mates.
His name is Jacob.
Well, yeah, whatever.
Is that what you wanted to tell me?
No, of course not. Like I said, me and Marley...
me and Jacob. We're your business partners. I don't know what he was up to the night he got himself shot, but for all I know, what he could have been on business.
Are you telling me you know something about the death of my son?
No. No, that's a mystery the good Lord doesn't want us to solve.
And you are in regular contact with the good Lord, are you?
Look, I want you to have this. I should have given it to you sooner. Think of it as Jacob's life insurance.
I don't want your blood money, Mr. Scrooge.
I'm trying to be nice here.
I don't want your money. Is that clear?
You're as stupid as your son, do you know that?
Is this one about five?
And what are you lot staring at? All right, Emma. Only Bob said he liked football, and I thought to myself, well, he could play a bit of football when his chest gets better.
His chest won't get better. That's not what happens with cystic fibrosis. It gets worse.
Well, you never know these days. I mean, scientists are always coming up with new things. Now they've discovered DVD. Well, disease could be a thing of the past. And if it costs, I'd like to help out. But within reason, of course.
Oh, thanks. You're all heart.
Hiya.
Oh, hello. What are you doing here?
Oh, I've just been to see this sick kiddie I know. Gave him his Christmas present. Football gear, I mean, it's not cheap, but, well, only once a year.
All right.
Bella. Can we go out for a drink tonight?
I've got plans.
Yeah, I know you're seeing Julie, but...
How do you know that?
Well, you always do. Look, I won't keep you long. I really need to tell you something.
I don't think so, Eddie. Merry Christmas.
Big issue, mister. Big issue.
Can I have a word?
Get out of here!
Oi! Slow down!
Leave us alone!
Stay here.
Get some help.
You've got to stay here. Bella? Bella? I need you to come with me.
Well, there's an invitation that no girl should ever accept.
Shut up, Julie. I need her.
Yeah? Well, I need Brad Pitt and a bottle of baby oil. But I don't think either of us are going to get lucky this year, do you?
I need your help. There's a street kid, I think that she's gonna die.
Oh, please! Oh, talk about a cheap shot.
It's the truth. You've gotta believe me.
Oi, listen to me. You're mad. This is really mad.
Where is she?
Just round the corner on the estate.
I'll come take a look.
Oh, please, Lord, give this girl the sense she was born with. I won't be long. Oh, you don't think I'm letting you go on your own, do you?
Call an ambulance.
I thought it'd be quicker to get you.
Julie, call an ambulance.
Give us your phone, mate.
She's round here. God, I told you not to move.
Where you been? You've been ages.
She looks sick, and I wanted to help her. That's why I came and got you.
Okay.
What's she doing? She's going to be all right, isn't she?
Should have called a bloody ambulance.
Was she going to be all right or what?
What's her name, love?
What are you doing to her?
Answer the question.
Jude.
Come on, Jude. Come on.
What's wrong with her?
I don't know. Could be pneumonia, hypothermia.
Well, you aren't going to help her, though, are you?
And where's the ambulance?
On its way. What have you done to her?
I've done nothing to her. I'm the one that's trying to save her life here.
Why? How much does she owe you? Just shut up.
Please. Please!
Bella, let me take over.
Oh,
No. No, Jude, no!
What are you doing? What have you stopped for?
It's no use. I've lost her.
No, you're wrong. No. No. I'm not having this. You've got to do something. Well, come on, please. Please, come on, you've got to do something. Please, do something.
Is she going to be all right?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
What took the ambulance so long?
Ambulances won't come on the estate anymore without a police escort.
Well, don't say it like it's my fault.
Isn't it?
Oh, come on, I'm not like that. You saw how I tried to save that kid's life.
Then why didn't you call an ambulance straight away?
Like I said, I thought you'd be quicker.
That isn't the only reason, is it?
Of course it is.
Why me? Why did you come for me? I want the truth.
Yeah, well, you always were big on the truth, weren't you?
Eddie!
All right. I suppose a part of me wanted you to see that I could care. I wanted you to see that I changed.
Well, you haven't really changed at all then, have you?
Oh, come in, Marley. So, did you fancy telling me where I went wrong this time?
Well, you made the changes everywhere except where it counts. In air. Well, in there.
What do you people want? Miracles? It's all right for you. You're dead. I have to live in the real world.
You call what you're doing living in the real world? I call it a man hiding behind a big fat lie.
Oh, yeah? And what lie would that be?
Well, how about my death? That wouldn't be a bad start.
Your death? What would I know about your death?
Just who did it and why?
Well, if I knew that, I'd have gone to the police, wouldn't I?
Not if you thought it was bad for business, you wouldn't. Come on. Tell me. I need to wear it. There's just you and me here. And I'm in no state to turn Queen's Counsel, am I? For me? Yeah. For old time's sake. Would you just please put me out of my misery?
I told Ricky Stiles where you'd be making a pickup that night.
I know.
I swear that's all I told him. I didn't know he was going to shoot you. I promise. I just thought he was going to shake you up a bit.
I know.
If I'd known that he was going to... I'd never have done that to you, Marley. I really wouldn't.
So you set me up.
You got greedy. He was just supposed to scare you.
So you set me up?
Yeah. I set you up.
I know. I knew as soon as I died.
If you knew all along, then why did you beg me to tell you?
Because it's good for you to confess. Conscience-wise.
Not for what it's worth, there isn't a day that goes by on it. I was mad at you. It was just a moment. A stupid, angry, no-going-back moment, and if I could turn the clock back, I would. If I could change the way I live my life, I'd do it. But I can't. You think I like being me? I hate being me. Molly. Molly. Jacob! I know you, don't I? You're off the estate, aren't you? You're it, aren't you? You're the ghost of Christmas future. I mean, don't you people ever give up? Has Tim gone home?
I've been to the cemetery. They found a smashing spot for Tim. Vicar was a lovely bloke. He's bald, but he's very nice with it. He'll be doing the service. I wish you'd have come with me.
I couldn't.
It's very peaceful up there, you know, with grass and trees. And I told Tim that we go up there and have a talk with him every week.
Oh, my lad. My poor little lad.
So I thought if I could move back in.
No.
Just till after the funeral.
It's no good, Bob.
No. Look, I could help with the children. It's hard enough for them. They need me.
Oh, it won't help to fill him with false hope. It'll make it harder when you move back out. It won't work.
We should be together at a time like this.
We should have always been together, Bob. But you made your choice.
This hasn't got anything to do with Scrooge.
You carried on working for him. I'm sorry.
No, don't be like this, Sue. Please, not today. Please, not today. What about me, eh? Sue! What about me?
But Tim Cratchit was happy while he was alive. I mean, that's got to count for something, hasn't it? Would you just answer me that?
Do you like this?
I thought he'd never die.
I know justice isn't mine to give, but, well, the man lived by violence. And once you're on that road, it can only end in one place.
Well, put like that, I don't feel so guilty.
Mum, can I have this?
No, put that back.
They're scared that they're floggy. Where's it from? Will you just tell me what's going on? You know, I wish you'd shut up for 10 minutes. Bella. Is that what you wanted me to see, Bella and Day? Is this some kind of torture? You all have had enough torture for one Christmas. That was my stuff, wasn't it? They were flogging my stuff, weren't they? I get the message. Look, I don't want to see anymore. Just tell me this. Are these the things that will happen, or just the things that might happen? I know I've been useless. I know I've wasted my life. I can see what I've got to do now. I mean, the Cratchits don't have to tear each other apart. Those kids don't need to die. People don't have to suffer because of me. I won't look at that grave. God. No. No. Just tell me. Do I get a chance to put things right? Just tell me that. Please. Please.
Yeah, I'm after a flight to Australia for tomorrow. Most expensive one you've got. I'll call you back. Bob, how's Tim?
Well, he's not so well, actually. We're all spending Christmas at the hospital.
Right, so he'll be needing his dad at a time like this.
And his mum, yeah.
And you'll be wanting to spend more time with him.
Well, it'd be nice, just over the holidays, but as my own mum used to say, you know, it's no use having butter if you don't own a palm cake.
Did she really? What a wise woman. Oh, I know what it was I wanted to tell you. You're sacked.
What? But I can work Christmas.
You're sacked, Bob. I'm letting you go.
But what about the money I owe you?
I'll write it off. Small price to pay for getting rid of you, Bob. You're useless.
But, hey? What do I do?
You think I care? Then go on, get out of my sight. Well, go on! Sit down. Excuse me.
Yes?
She's got hypothermia and pneumonia.
Yes.
That's her brother Lee. He's got pneumonia as well. They've been living rough.
What's the name?
It's Jude.
Who are you?
Mrs. Marley.
Have you come to bully us or mock us, Mr. Scrooge?
No, I've come to say I'm sorry about Jacob. He was a good bloke. And I can't imagine what it must be like to lose a son. But I won't rest until we find the man who did it. Try and have a good Christmas, Mrs. Marley.
Do you really mean that?
Well, there is something you could do for me, then you'll know that I mean it.
Is this one about 5 feet?
Could you excuse me a minute? Hold on.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, thank you.
Who is he?
It's me, it's Eddie.
Oh, horrified.
Merry Christmas, Eric.
Sorry about that, but I come over all quaint when I saw you smile.
Well, I'm sorry I shocked you, Eric. Why didn't you see me?
Oh, there'll be no need for any of that.
Well, come on, a fool like that, what's it worth? I mean, if you worked in the city, have your lawyers onto it straight away. Stress, loss of earnings, doctor's bills.
Oh, he'll be righteous rain as soon as he's tasted this tinned ham.
Let's say $1,000 for the stress, $2,000 for the loss of earnings, I think, and another grand for doctor's bills. Well, Eric, you've taken me to the cleaners, and I'd like to be the first to shake your hand. Merry Christmas.
Mum.
You're early.
Yeah, I've been...
We've got some news.
So have I. Look, I've been sacked, love.
Oh, Bob, listen to me. None of it matters. We won the premium bonds.
What?
We won the premium bonds. £50,000. We got the letter, the cheque and everything this morning.
We didn't.
Oh, Bob, we're going to have the best Christmas ever.
Oh, we are. We really are.
Yeah, we are.
No, it's funny, though, isn't it?
It's bloody hilarious. No,
it's funny we won. We haven't got any premium bonds.
Dad.
Hey. Hello, darling.
Oh.
Let's have a look. Look at the cheque. Boy, maybe your Judith sent it from Australia.
Oh, come on, she's an Avon lady, Bob. Even Judith couldn't tell that much apple-flavoured lip gloss.
Well, maybe Mr. Scrooge sent it.
Oh. Yeah, that's right. Oh, yeah, Mr. Scrooge is well good at handing out his money, isn't he?
You lovely, sweet lad.
Good, Av, you never know.
You're a lot to learn about the world, ain't you, son?
Mrs. Cratchit?
That's right, yeah.
And this is Tim, I take it.
That's right.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee rise. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in the dark street shineth the
buy you a drink.
Actually, I'm on duty, Uncle Eddie.
All right. Well, I don't quite know how to tell you this, but if you're interested, this is the man that shot Jacob Marley. Now, I've written his name down in case you arrest the wrong bloke. I know what you lot are like.
He starts. You sure?
He keeps a gun in the safe at the back of his club.
How long have you known this?
Well, I knew that Jacob was meeting Stiles. I also knew that Stiles thought that Jacob was moving in on his patch, so you could say that I've known all along.
But you were too scared to come forward, were you?
No, I was too greedy. I knew that we'd be bad for business if Stiles was picked up.
Come on. Business partner had just been killed. This can't have just been about money.
I'm afraid it was.
So, why are you telling me this now?
Let's just say I found a conscience in my Christmas stocking.
So? I was just wondering if you'd come over for Christmas dinner.
I'd love to. I bloody well love to. And tell that wife of yours to expect a turkey big enough to aspire with Mike's eyes.
Actually, we're vegetarians.
All right, the biggest nut roast she's ever seen. Oh, and Merry Christmas. I was just lost. I thought this was a snooker hall.
Well, we get a lot of that this time of year. She's a lot better, by the way.
Oh, good. Good. Whoever she is.
No, no. You were spotted, Eddie. Julie saw you bringing them in.
No, she was mistaken.
No, she said it was you. She said all you needed was a puppy and you'd look like a hero.
Yeah, well, it is Christmas.
What's happened to you?
It's over. My old life. The old me. Gone.
What brought this on?
Do you really want to know?
Let me get this right. The last ghost was someone you knew. A child.
I felt like a name. I don't know where from. It was more like I was going to know him. Does any of this make sense?
Don't worry, none of this makes any sense.
You think I'm making it up? Give me some credit. My only chance to win you back, and I come up with a lie like this. It's got to be the truth, hasn't it? I mean, it happened.
How come none of this stuff happens to anyone else?
Maybe it does. Maybe they just don't know it. Well, maybe it happened to me because of who I was or what I was. And if you're living a life as bad as mine, well, it's going to take something pretty massive to change it. I'm not asking you to believe me straight away. I know you don't trust me. But I'm changing. Well, I've changed completely. Almost completely.
And what's left of the old you? Your ego?
No. The part of me that never stopped loving you. Nothing could change that. Look, I'm gonna go now, but if you change your mind, I'll be waiting.
Eddie. Did you bring any mistletoe?
Thank you.
Merry Christmas. Hey.
Happy Christmas, love. Oh, it's such a happy Christmas. I love it.
I'll ever show you my my triple X
suit. Did it look like falling over?
Maybe. To the untrained eye. So, you sure it's on, Sonia?
Yeah.
How do we look? Okay.
Like old farts.
Oi!
Oh, my God!
Come on, I want you and your mum, yeah?
Don't have those.
Come on! Yeah. Lovely!
It's my baby boy.
We're holding him a minute.
Oh, come on!
All right, I'm not making the Olympics.
You only met the trials.
Wait.
Smile.
Oh, no.